In this lesson, we'll be talking about new lines and text paragraphs in HTML. We are seeing here two different headings and they show on different lines. That makes us think that they show on different lines because they are on different lines in our code. But the truth is, the browser doesn't care about the times you press enter in your code. See that this doesn't change how the result is displayed on the browser. Moreover, if you put everything on the same line, it's gonna show exactly the same. The reason why we place these elements in different lines is simply to make it more readable for us, human beings. What if I wanna show two different paragraphs of text? For example, I want to learn coding and then find free resources on zenva.com. Say I wanna have this in two different lines. As you probably guessed, it's gonna show in a single line, even if I add as many enters as I want. It's still gonna show in one line. So the way for us to actually create paragraphs is by using the P tag, which is a HTML tag that stands for paragraph and that allows you to tell the browser, hey browser, we're about to start a paragraph here. So everything that comes after the P is a paragraph. And when you close the paragraph, you're basically telling the browser, hey browser, we've finished our paragraph. Now just please skip a new line. So as you can see, that gives us two different paragraphs of text. Just like before, I could really show absolutely everything on one single line and the result on the browser will be the same. But then again, we are human beings and we need to read things in a way that's easy for us. We're not machines. We can't read a line of text that has 1 million characters, right? So that's the basic of text paragraphs and new lines in the browser. Remember, it is HTML tags that tell the browser how to display this content, as in what it is that we're trying to display. But having said so, it will be when we learn CSS that we'll really have the capacity to modify these default behaviors and make elements show the way we want with regards to spacing, how much separation there will be in between them. That's all handled by CSS. For now, we are relying on a default style that the browser provides, and we're learning how to tell the browser what it is that we want to show,